I guess maybe one thing we haven't covered is we had this sort of other motivation in terms of the upgrade of the space was that we make sauerkraut here on the farm. And so we realized that if we are needing to meet, you know, all these produce safety regulations, we could also, it's basically very similar standards in order to license the space as a food processing space. So so we just kind of did those simultaneously. So we installed a hand washing sink that is plumbed to our septic system and a 3-bay stainless steel dishwashing sink. And those two elements essentially bring us up to like a food processing status, and you know, in conjunction with all the other stuff that we did for produce safety with washable walls and washable floors and everything. Before we installed the hand washing sink, we had a very kind of rustic hand washing setup. So this, it feels great to have like a legit sanitary hand washing. It was a good investment through the Department of Health. Yeah, and he, that person comes to the farm, and he came for us. He came when we had roughed everything in and confirmed our plans, and then came for a final inspection. And I wouldn't say it was like particularly rigorous or difficult. It's just another set of rules you got to make sure you're following. And and it was worth it for us. We're happy with it. I would say it already has resulted in increased sales. Particularly for our sauerkraut, we just have the ability to make kraut at different times throughout the season, and so we used to just make it all in one batch because we were taking it off-site to produce it. So now we can make it kind of as needed, and then just the efficiencies that we've created, we can just process so much veg through this space in with one person, whereas before we used to have like two or three people trying to organize all the produce coming in from the field. So I think that we're definitely seeing increased revenue from it. We're really happy with the space. I mean, maybe just a piece of advice is like any kind of construction project like this is just sort of having realistic expectations about cost and timeline, because I think we always get in our minds like how we gotta get these things done, and they take time. And as you'll see, there's like many unfinished elements still. And we've done enough of these now that we've learned to just try to be patient, and we'll get it done eventually. And just be easy on yourself trying to get through the process, because any kind of big construction project, yeah, it just costs a lot of money and takes time. I think that we really appreciated the wisdom of, like, we had a little consultation with all four extension agents. So so meeting with all four of those folks together gave us a really good, strong kind of foundation for this project, just because we had their advice in all of the sort of ways that we were approaching it, you know, in terms of our finances and our organization and our planning, and then just the technical expertise of Chris Callahan. I appreciate how well-rounded their advice was, and that they were kind of available for questions and advice throughout the process, not just in that one meeting that we had. So